Yeah, I've got dust.
Do you have that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do. Sources. Your sources, at any... whenever you get stun, a Nighthound lanes bottom, you come and kill him. I bought dust. Your behi from yesterday's match was excellent, alright. Thank you, sir. Okay, guys, I'm gonna try to put this on YouTube, so...
think he's gonna pull?
He might try. Alright, guys, welcome to this CD Educational, or gameplay, whatever you wanna call it. We'll see what happens. Currently I failed the last two games. Who cares if it's level 1? I'm CD against Chipper, Tempest, Ravenor, Nighthound, Myrmidon. So their team is okay against CD. As soon as I get my Shrunken, the only ones I have to watch out for are Tempest and Ravenor. So perhaps I'll be doing okay. Skill build is usually maxing QW. Depending on my opinion, whether or not they have a physical core that you can easily steal damage from, then you want to max your W, otherwise your Q. I'll go over the skills later, why I do what. The Q obviously goes up in damage. Also, the damage is greater the farther the enemy is from you, and damage is dealt on both the expansion and contraction of the tide. So when you Q and they're close to you, you want to run away so they get hit further away on the Q to deal more damage. Target an enemy to grant vision around them, lower the attack damage and increase your own. Basically, you drain damage with the spell. The E spell gives you a passive move speed bonus, and it deals damage to them if they use a spell on you, and they're slowed. Your ulti is just like a little electric thing that targets the lowest HP target close to you. For every time it hits, it deals minus armor and deals physical damage. So yeah, let's see what's going to happen. We're most likely going to be against a Nighthound. So that's why I got the dust, and I believe we can manage to kill him really easily, especially with a solstice rotation with a stun. Should be very simple. Hi Mal, nice comeback yesterday, thank you so much. Okay, usual item build for CD is, like, there's a very standard item build, which is, Steam Boots, Energizer, Shrunken, and then you can literally go anything from there. Sometimes people go, like, Steam Boots, Energizer, Firebrand, Shrunken, but, like, the Steam Boots, Energizer, Shrunken is usually your tri-core of items, I would say. Then there's, like, a Dawnbringer, Wingbow, Genjuro, etc., etc. Coming. You have a sentry. I need to see where he goes. I need to see where he goes.
Nice.
This is why you get dust, niggas. Alright, see? My friends, this is why you buy dust. Even level 1. You can just buy dust, it's no problem. It doesn't have to be the support that does it. I feel like people nowadays are too focused that, oh, the support, he's the bitch, he has to spend the money on the items that aren't that good. You take this creep, I go lane. And it's like, no, yesterday I played Berserker in a tournament game, and I bought, like, I swear to God, we rotated me to short lane from long lane. Aiden Insania did not have money. I bought 3 wards and 2 counter wards straight up for 500 gold on our core Berserker just to help out our team and make sure we get it all done. Creep Juice, thank you for the sub, buddy. I really appreciate it. Thanks for being in the stream and supporting me. Thank you so much. I'm gonna buy early boots here. Just so we can put more pressure on the Nighthound and perhaps kill him. I have boots, by the way, so if he comes over, we can kill him.
I will kill him, man.
Oh, can we go? Can we go? Can we go? Come, 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 come.
Run, run.
On my way, I have no boots, man. I'm stunning him. Yes, easy.
That's
Can you buy new dust, Hugo?
Yeah, I'm going for it.
Great.
Rune bottom illusion.
Also, make sure when you drain someone, you don't just want to start hitting right away. You usually want to keep running at them, get more damage, and then start attacking. Just to have like more efficiency on it, really. And this Lighthound is pretty much dead at any point he shows. Okay, if we get dust, he's fucking dead again.
I'm gonna run through river.
We have dust. The lane control is a bit bad right now.
Maybe wait for me, guys.
Yeah. Okay, as I said, I'm gonna go sea boots here. There we go. I got my sea boots finished. I'm gonna be maxing W this game. But simply because I'm up against a Nighthound, a Ravenor, like I'm up against heroes that are pretty much gonna be in my face, so it should be very easy to drain damage. Also, no, my W does not keep clear vision. It gives clear vision, yes, but not through invisibility. If he comes here to last hit, you run and you go, okay, and we kill him. Yeah. So far we're doing really good in this match. I'm sitting on 430 GPM, we got 2 kills on a Nighthound. I have close to flawless creep kills at this point. Sometimes I like to skip ulti at 6, it depends on like what is happening. Because the ulti value, like you need to be able to run after someone for a while to get value out of it. I'm gonna be pushing the bottom wave. Simply because Nighthound is not bottom right now, I'm gonna push it, force him to come here. And I actually want him to come here, because I feel like we can get some pretty easy kills on that guy.
He's here, can you use dust?
The dust is on me. Like, if I can force him to come here, not only do I take the pressure, I take the pressure away from Solstice, but I also force him to come bottom, and perhaps I get, like, we can kill him. Also, very important tip, I'm gonna buy a teleport. I have a teleport, if they dive you anywhere, please scream. Like, this guy thinks he can just... Like, I'm not an idiot, he can't do that against me. I will kill him. Like, and he won't deal damage to me. So basically, if you drain someone... For a while, like you're only up against the tower. Who cares if you're tanking tower if you're not tanking the hero?
Subscribe.
Like the value of W as well is so high. Alp Rexden 88, thank you for the sub. Guys, big shout out to Creep Juice it was, and Alp Rexden 88. Thank you guys so much for subbing. Thanks for being in the stream. Thanks for supporting me. Going on with the game, as I said, I decided to skip my W here because I feel like. Lower mana cost, easier efficiency, etc. Nighthound is missing from bottom, care on the other lanes. I'm gonna be buying an energizer. Okay, Nighthound is back. Once I get an energizer, like, it's pretty much free kills anywhere. I just wanna... Okay, he already has boots. I'm gonna need the courier soon. I have energizer. Maybe I should go Alkbones, actually. Think about going Alkbones here, because this game is most likely gonna go fairly late. Actually, I think I'm going Alphons. I'm going Alphons here. I feel like it's actually gonna be hard for me to outcarry a Ravenor because I wanna go for those Alphons, secure the late game a little bit. Yo, if anyone comes, we really should kill this Nighthound again. This is free kill all the time. Gonna deny this creep.
Okay, still top.
Yeah, I'm gonna be going for Alphons here. Okay, let's see what's... I'm gonna push in the tower again. I want Nighthound to be here. I don't want him to roam on my sources, etc. Oh, I missed that last hit. Not good of me. Oh, I missed 2 last hits. Not good. Gonna end up selling Minor Totem here to get the Alkbones faster. Okay, got Alkbones now. Gonna use my Q to push in the wave.
Finish night. Merm going bottom. The refreshable.
Yeah.
I got the carry.
Nice kill, mate. Come, doc. Okay, if we're gonna keep pushing here. Myrmidon is coming, we're fine. I have a teleport ready at any time. Just go. Doctor.
Go!
Oh, wow. Oh! Nice job. Tower. I'm gonna dust. Actually, I highly doubt he will go for it. That's stupid. Alright, next item is gonna be... and hello, KheZu, just wanna let you know that you are awesome. Keep up the good work streaming, bro. Thank you so much, buddy. I appreciate it. Hi, KheZu, amazing work yesterday at BE Making was epic. Thank you. Legendary Haw, thank you guys for the subs. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Guys, please give it up for Creep Juice, Albrexton88, and Legendary Haw. I hope that's how I am supposed to pronounce all of your names, guys. I appreciate it. Next item is an energizer for me here. Not sure if I wanna go staff or just a full carry route. I feel like staff could be good. I feel like teamfights might be longer paced in this lineup, because we all have pretty tanky heroes and a bit of mobility and like Tempest Holes and Solstice Slows, etc. So I feel like a staff could be good. I feel like staff is very good in prolonged, like when you feel like there's gonna be longer teamfights, staff is really good. Also, I actually feel like staff is close to a core item on this hero.
They know.
Pink is coming.
Alright, gonna fall back to the jungle real quick. I need to use my outpost. I need to steal this camp from you, Solstice.
It's okay.
Jupiter just scouted here in the jungle, so they probably don't have vision here.
Maybe to head top? I don't know.
I have a tele. Oh, I'm running middle. I'm running mid. I think we can get a kill mid, we just straight up gank it. Oh, he hit me with a rocket, fuck it. Keep in mind, you wanna run away when your Q hits them, cause it deals more damage the further away you are.
Maybe I'll manage.
Oh, it's triple strike? Okay, nice. I think I'll come kill it later. Oh, you guys need to help him. I'm gonna stack this camp and camp the bottom room. That's a very nice kill by my team. Refreshment room bottom.
What?
Someone farm top. Alright, level 9, I'm gonna get my ulti here just because. It's not that good to Alcbones as Skelly King, but fuck it, I'll just do it. It's the in terms of gold, it's the worst creep to do. In terms of experience, I'm fairly sure it's the highest. So it's not that bad. I need the Choreo next if possible. Hello, KheZu, a big fan here. Twitch sucks because I cannot verify my Twitch account and your stream requires everyone to have a verified account. Can you remove this? I will try. I do it sometimes because...
I have to.
I do it sometimes, simply... I'm ready.
He's gonna go for the archer, we kill him.
Can you run in? Run in. I do it sometimes because there was a lot of spam in the past on my stream. And that's why I just removed it. Because, like, people that, like, have spam bots, for example. That's why I did it.
Maybe not.
We should not be afraid here, Can we go?
Yeah.
This is really nice, keep it up. Blow it. Beautiful. And we got him. Just gonna run him down, hit him, and he's gonna die here. This game is going really good so far. I wanna show you guys the execution of a good Corrupted Disciple teamfight. Because in theory, what you want to do is, you want to drain one guy, but hit the other one. Like, let's say I drain the Nighthound, and I hit the Ravenor. The Nighthound is going to run away from me, so I run with him. But at the same time, I keep hitting the Ravenor. Like, I don't need... The guy you drain, you don't need to hit, because he's useless anyways. Because you're not going to drain a spellcaster, right? You're going to drain one of their physical heroes. What is a physical hero going to do without damage? Nothing. So what you do is you drain the guy, but you kill his team. Because basically, you force the fight to be 4-on-5 by draining that one hero you drain. And at the same time, you gain bonus damage to hit one of the other heroes. You just have such high value in a team fight, and if you perform that correct, The value of a CD in a teamfight with a high drain is very high. He's going outbones as well on Ravenor. I think we're back here.
Knight on deck here.
Yeah, we have.
Oh. Congratulations on DreamHack, bro. Thanks. A bit late, but thank you. What does Saf do on CD? Okay. So what do your ulti da- Oh, yo. Do we have dust on anyone? Energizing us? Do you have mech? Who's gonna get by that? This is so nice. No! my bad. I'm actually gonna buy back for this. I think early buybacks when you have outbones are worth it. Because right now I spend 400 gold to not be dead for half a minute. I also get to use my charges right now instead of it being low on cooldown. It's more of a Dota thing to do that people don't really do in Han so much. There's a difference that obviously Han has buyback limit, but I don't think I will be using my two buybacks this game. A staff on CD, it makes it bounce twice. Like, it goes once and then it bounces again. I don't know if it bounces twice, I believe it bounces. Like, the guy you hit, it bounces off him twice more. And it also shoots faster. So the ulti becomes a lot stronger. It's like more of an AoE instead of just one. It would be nice to see how far you can drain, like, the range while in fight. They should use a bomb between targets. I don't know if they need to do that. I feel like it's good that they don't have that. I feel like it would simplify the game a lot. But it's not a bad idea. Okay, so let's see. I'm not gonna use my outbones here, because there's nothing to drain on. I'm gonna push up bottom, we're gonna try to get this tower down. My next item is gonna be a fire. Actually, I don't know, I kinda like to go staff. Your staff makes me so tanky against their team, and in like, if I just stay alive, it's gonna do so much work. I actually think I'm gonna be going aiming for a staff with the master here. Cause the glowstone and the mighty bait are gonna do so much for me at this point. Let's try to get this tower. Yeah, we're gonna be getting this tower. I think Alton's was the right choice here. Cause we didn't need to teamfight them. But even though we did, it didn't really hurt me that much. Like, it gave me some bonus, in my opinion, so it was good. I'm gonna get a glowstone here. I wanna use my outbound charges. Can we dive mid this way? We should dive mid here. Like, if you can collapse on a team from all angles, where are they gonna go? Either they TP in, and you already outnumber them, or they give up their hero, because he's, like, if you come from all angles, where is he gonna go? He can't go anywhere, right? Because he's cornered. I think the build-up for staff is really good on CD. You get like a lot of HP from it, and also mana, and then the effect of staff is so good. In Dota, you can gold if you buy because early, early buy because you use it. Oh, I'm sorry. They must have changed that a while ago.
Is W over here?
I have no cooldown.
Yo, if we see someone, I'm okay. Can we cancel this? Oh no. Or is Rappled? Easy game. Let's get the tower. This game is fairly over. We played this game really well. From bottom lane to mid lane to Plague doing work top. This was pretty good. Oops. Let's see what we can do here. 700 for... I need 600 for staff going bottom. Gonna finish my staff and we can do more. Do you always keep one charge on Alchemist? I usually do, because you... In theory, you want to hold it for a Vagabond leader. The Alchemist, that is. But, yeah. Why don't you use both charges of Alchemist? Yeah, because usually you, like, in the time, you can just wait to get a better creep, you know? How did you do that? How did you use a bottle charge on me?
I
Oh, okay.
Lol.
Yeah, I was confused. It's a Dota thing. Using bottle on other people. Let's go mid. Alright, I got the staff now. Like, look how tanky I am now, just with these. Basically with these three items, which are... Like, it doesn't cost that much. It's 1500, 1500, 4k. It's 7000 gold. And now it buffs my ulti really, like, a lot. Like, it... Keep in mind, the ulti also deals minus armor. So the guy you hit over and over, he takes minus armor. And, okay, so first of all, your ulti bounces plus 1 second faster. Which doesn't seem like a lot. But it really stacks up, because it's already low in the first place. And then it bounces twice. So, like, it... First of all, you can farm faster. In a team fight... In a team fight, it will bounce to multiple targets instead of just one. So the damage increase, the straight up value of the item is very high. What do you think? What is your thought about lasting towers instead of Legion help when getting the kill? You should always let creeps kill the tower unless your hard carry is 1, close to Rune Cleaver, 2, your initiator gets a PK off the tower kill. Otherwise, you should always give it to creeps because that means you get overall more gold. Just keep me in the front. And we're fine. I don't want to get Tempest on here, so I'm gonna position here. I don't see them executing this teamfight. Okay, that is definitely not how they're gonna execute it. I can tell you that much. So multi is doing really good. I'm gonna head on the Tempest. There's Rap's ult. Taunting, boys.
Holy shit.
Ah, these guys are pretty f-
Yo, 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 Zebi!
Yo, yo, yo! Alright, so basically, my next item would be either a Dawnbringer, a Wingbow, a Shrunken, a Gijuro. CD is very versatile in terms of what you actually go on the hero. I don't think there's just one build. Like, you can go the Staff route, you can go early Shrunken, you can go a Dawnbringer and farm, you can go a Shroud and like try to gank, be more the positioning type of hero. I like to go PK on this hero so I can just blink. Like, I like the PK Shrunken combo on this hero. So, like, I like PK Shrunken so I can just blink. I can just blink on one of the heroes, you know? Sadly, I couldn't get them killed. I like the PK Shrunken combo on this hero because you can just blink in, use Shrunken, and like drain their carry. Because their carry, like as always, the carry can't man up on you. Because you're draining his damage, so he's forced to run away. If he mans up, you wreck him. And since you're shrunken, they can't really do much to you other than hit you. And then since you lock down the carry... Since you lock down the carry, he can deal physical damage to you. Thus meaning you're shrunken, you're sort of close to invulnerability. And I think that combo is just very good. I don't see anyone do it, but it's a pretty good combo. Can we go push top S5? I'm not sure what I'm gonna spend my gold on here, because this game is fairly over at this point. It doesn't really matter what I buy. Oh, one guy here, one guy here. Ravenor.
Yeah, Ravenor.
Bad drain. He has a storm on Buckley. Wow, these slows. That's obviously why a Shrunken is really good. Like, you don't want to get stunned or slowed and shit as CD, because you're very reliant on your high move speed, your high mobility in team fights to chase around people. No fire on CD thoughts? Not sure if I like that. Do you never go lifesteal? I like to go lifesteal late game. I don't think lifesteal should be a very early item on CD. It could be like your 4th, 5th, or 6th item. Something like that, but not before, in my opinion. No, not before that. I also think Shieldbreaker is an underrated item on this hero. Don't think it's that good, because you usually want Lifesteal later on. But, I mean, this game is sort of over at this point.
I got you back, mate.
Yo, can we just go? They don't have Tempest Hole, guys. Attack this
structure. I'm here. I will cancel it anyway.
Okay, I'm just telling you, I don't want to be in the front. Oh. We dance slow this wave and hit the tower. Everyone. Everyone but Rhapsody. As you can, like, the minus armor for Shieldbreaker really synergizes with your ulti, also dealing minus, like, also minus armor, and then obviously you have the... I mean, like, obviously you have the... What is it called?
Game Boy.
I don't even know what the fuck I'm talking about. Like, you're very reliant on physical damage, your W gives you attack damage, your ulti lowers armor, your Shieldbreaker lowers armor, so it's, like, it synergizes very well together. Rocky, like, my cats must be the most vocal cats on Earth. Ginjuro's awesome on CD? Yeah, definitely is. Holy snits. Hey, guys, a nice copy because did the trash talk work? Of course it is. Of course it is. Alright, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this CD game. I will... think I'm gonna go for another video, but yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did enjoy it, make sure you follow my stream and my social medias, especially Facebook. It would be really nice. I would appreciate it. Other than that, hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll try to go for another video now. Let's see what happens in the next game. But thank you guys for watching so far.